This is the first episode, and here we'll create a weather app using ChatGPT. ChatGPT is an AI or artificial intelligence chatbot developed by OpenAI and launched in November 2022. You can ask ChatGPT anything you'd like to know, such as general knowledge questions about science, technology, history, personal advice, help with code, poems, content, cover letters, and many more. Now, let's get started. First, you need to open the official website of ChatGPT. Then click on this button called Try ChatGPT. If you are a new user, you can click on the Sign Up button. If you are the existing one, click on Login. I want to log in using my Gmail account, so click Continue with Google. You can choose your account. And this is the landing page of ChatGPT. If you want to upgrade them to Plus, you can click on this link. And when you pay $20 per month, you will get extra feature like this. For now, I'm happy with my free plan. So let me close this modal box. Now let's start typing the message. Let's start with the greeting saying hi ChatGPT. It will then respond to us saying hello, how can I assist you today? Let me then ask them, I need some help making weather app using HTML, CSS and JavaScript. In response, it says, sure, I can help you. And it is also providing us with some general step to begin with. For example, we need a design, then we need HTML, CSS, API, and so on. It is also giving us some example code to get started. So the first one is the HTML code. Then it is generating the CSS code. And finally, it is generating the JavaScript code for us. Although you get this HTML, CSS, and JavaScript code, if you feel confused, or if you want another HTML code, you can always ask, I need HTML code for example. ChatGPT always save our conversation over here. So whenever you say I need HTML code, it understand that you're asking HTML code for the weather app. So as you can see over here, it is generating a new HTML code for the weather app. If you are happy with this code, you can simply copy the code. You can open your code editor. You can create a project folder. I have created a weather. Create a new file. Choose HTML and you can paste the code. You can save them under the weather folder. And I will call this file index. Then let's ask ChatGPT for the CSS code. So I will say I need CSS code. It is now generating the CSS code for this project. Once ready, you can copy this code, go back to your code editor, add new file, CSS, you can paste the code and save them as style.css. Once done, let's check the preview and we can see the weather app is looking very nice. Now let's add some interaction using JavaScript. So let's ask, I need JavaScript code. Now it is generating the JavaScript code for us. Once done, you can copy the code, create a new file in your code editor, choose JavaScript and paste your code. You can save them as script.js. Let's confirm in index.html and it is script.js. Now we need to add API key for open weather map. So in the browser, in new tab, search open weather, open the first link, click sign in, if you are a new user you have to create an account, otherwise you can enter your email or password and click submit. To get the API, go to your account and click My API Keys. You can copy the key and paste them over here. Once done, check the site. You can enter the city name, Reading for example. Click Get Weather and you can see it is working. So you can see how ChatGPT can be used to create simple applications. I will also show you how to add new data in this app. So go back to your code editor. You can copy this URL and add them under the notepad. Where it says city, you can replace them with the real city name. I will say Reading. And where it says the API key, you can add your own API key. Copy this URL and open the Postman software. Whenever you work on API, this software will make your life easier and it is free to download. Since we are getting data from OpenWeather, click on Get Request. Then on top, you can paste your URL and click Send. So these are the data that we can use in our application. Currently, we are using description and the name. But now I want to include country as well. So go back to your code editor. I will copy the city name variable and replace them with the country name. Hence, the country is under SYS and country. I will change them to data.sys.country. Now in this widget text, I want to include the country name. Once done, check the site, enter the city name, and now you can see the country name is added over here. Great. This is the end of this session. Feel free to comment below if you have any questions. Also, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to my channel to get more videos in the future. Thank you.